Government fails, but individuals succeed. That's the subtitle of my new book. And government failure is one of the reasons that the founders wanted limited government. They feared big government. And one reason we get big government is that many of our elected officials become career politicians. And the research shows the longer they're in Congress, the more they vote to spend. So, Leo Lindbeck and Mark Meckler want to shake Congress up by bringing in new blood. So, how?
Well, the main thing that we're trying to do is we're trying to fix the election process for congressional incumbents. I mean, right now, congressional incumbents don't really face competition. And we think that that really leads to the system breaking down.
So you're spending your own money to give people competition.
Right.
How does that work?
We engage in primary elections. You know, people think that the election for Congress occurs in November, but it doesn't. 85% of districts are dominated by either the Republican Party or the Democratic Party. So the real decision over who serves in Congress is made in the primary election. So we want people, more people, to vote in the primary election, and we want real competition there. And the whole system is set up to get rid of competition.
So when incumbents are running unopposed, you oppose them. You find someone and try to get them out?
The way it works is this. We're looking for people who are long-term incumbents, people who are in a one-party district. We're not trying to change between Democrat or Republican. We got problems with both those parties, so we're just trying to get rid of incumbents.
Yeah, you don't take a position Republican or Democrat.
No.
Anti-incumbent.
It's neither party, and it's not necessarily anti-incumbent. It's incumbents who are disconnected. They poll unpopularly with their own constituents. We think people should be represented by people who actually represent them.
There are people who poll poorly with their own constituents, and yet they don't have opponents?
Well, last cycle in 2010, 62% of congressional incumbents had no primary opponent. They ran unopposed. And then they go into a general election where there's no competition. So what we're doing is where there is competition, where there is an opponent, we're engaging to kind of level the playing field. The incumbent has all the money, has access to lobby money, special interest money, and so we come in with our effort, and we basically tell the other side of the story. We get rid of this sort of message monopoly that an incumbent has.
You buy some ads, you help the challenger.
Absolutely.
And if you talk about the advantage of the incumbents, one is the franking privilege, they call it. They get to mail out free stuff if you're in Congress. And I thought, how big a deal could that be? They spend $10,000 on mail or something. But we got this list. They spend $300,000 on mailing garbage out. The top guy spent $487,000. Among the things he was promoting himself for was taking a stand against wasteful spending.
Well, isn't that great? And nobody has the money to counter that. So even if he had a challenger, that challenger doesn't have $400,000 to send out a mailing explaining this wasteful spending. And that's your money that's sending out their promotional materials promoting themselves.
So it's a sort of a government-funded promotion scheme to get them out in front and say, hey, look at us. We're doing this great stuff. And no one ever is there to tell the other side of the story.
And you've raised about $2 million so far. And any success?
Yes, we've had two races that we've won in an election, and I think we've also driven one incumbent out by just releasing our poll results. When the incumbent found out they only had the support of about 25% of the voters in their district, I think that particular incumbent decided maybe getting a lobbying job was a better deal right now.
Mark Twain said, politicians are like diapers. They must be changed often. And for the same reason.
For the same reason.
Now, some might say, look, if he's doing a good job, he'll be elected again and again and again. What's wrong with that?
There's nothing wrong with that. But you know what? They should not be making that pitch to the lobbyists and the people who are funding their campaign and giving these big campaign funds. They should be making that pitch to the people. They shouldn't be coming to us and saying, hey, we're good guys. Just let us run again. We're doing a good job. If that's true, go sell it to your district. Convince them. And we're going to be there to tell them all the other things that you won't tell them. And we'll let the voters decide.
Well, thank you, Mark, Leo.
Thank you.